everybody, welcome back, or welcome if you're new here. I am Phoebe, and I am doing yet another reading vlog. First of all, if I look red and sweaty, that's because I am red and sweaty, and that's because we're in the middle of a heat wave in Belgium once again, and I decided to go for a walk in the scorching sun. Why do I do this to myself? I don't know. But I really enjoy making these reading vlogs, and I love watching reading vlogs. And like, I watch other people's reading vlogs to like kinda get some inspiration on how to make these videos better. But I'm gonna ask you guys again, what do you think I could do to make these reading vlogs better and more entertaining? So if you have any constructive criticism, please don't be shy to leave them in the comments down below, because I really do want to make better content for you. Anyways, there's two books I surely, definitely want to read this week. I got them right here. The first book I want to read this week is Icebreaker. This book was like all over TikTok, like my TikTok feed a few months ago, and like people were raving about it, and I'm just gonna pick it up and see if it's worth the hype, because I mean, it was getting so hyped up on TikTok that I just eventually caved and bought myself a copy. So I'm gonna be reading this one in today's vlog, the first one I'm gonna read in this vlog. Apparently there's quite a bit of smut in here, spiciness. I'm not a fan of spiciness. I find reading smut extremely uncomfortable, and that's probably because I am indeed asexual and sex repulses me. Not my thing, but I'm gonna read this book nonetheless, because maybe it's not gonna be as bad. Maybe it's the smut doesn't overpower my review. The other book I really want to read this week is Solitaire by Alice Osman. I really want to read this book so I can like dive in a little bit more in the Heartstopper world. This book focuses mainly on Tori. It's like from Tori's point of view. Tori is Charlie's sister, from Charlie from Heartstopper, obviously. And it goes more in depth into the character that Tori is. I really like Tori in the graphic novels and the Netflix series. I think she's a really great character. She's like different and a little weird, but she's also very, very caring. Like, she cares deeply about Charlie and Oliver. I did read Nick and Charlie in my previous vlog, and I'm really excited to read this one now. Another exciting thing that's gonna happen during this vlog is that my parents are gonna drive me all the way over to Brussels so we can go book shopping in Waterstones. Waterstones Brussels is like the biggest bookstore in Belgium, and I'm like hella excited. Like, I cannot wait until it's Thursday so I can go book shopping in the biggest bookstore of Belgium, and obviously I'm taking you with me. But yeah, those are my reading plans for the week. Maybe I'll add another third book into that TBR. We'll see. Who knows? I probably will, unless I'm reading slowly this week. I don't force myself to read like a lot of books. I just read at my own pace. As for today, I once again woke up feeling unwell. Surprise, surprise. I just have these episodes where for like a week or two I just feel terrible physically, like lethargic and like just meh out of it. It happens. I know it happens. I deal with it. It's not nice. It's annoying, but it is what it is. So I did crash at like 2 p.m. and like took a nap. My nap ended up being 2.5 hours, but at least I felt better when I woke up, you know. There has to be some positives to this. But yeah, I woke up and I was gonna start filming, only to realize that my camera was dead. The battery was empty. So yeah, that happened. I was really pissed off at that point. I was not feeling well, I overslept in my nap, and then my camera was not charged. Don't we love life? Wow. But yeah, so it is indeed actually Monday evening. It's like 8 p.m. It's not that late, but why am I filming my intro at 8 p.m. when I was gonna do it in the morning? Because I felt sick, obviously. Why am I asking myself that question? Yeah, so I guess you'll have to spend the evening with me now. Because, you know, I'm gonna read Icebreaker. I'm gonna read Icebreaker, a bit of this. I'm gonna watch Katie's new reading vlog, because she... because she just posted a new reading vlog, well, just like 2 hours, 3 hours ago. So I'm gonna watch that one and just have some tea and just chill with my books and just let this day go, because it was not the best. But yeah, that's all I... Oh, I've been rambling for so long, haven't I? Yeah. I'm gonna shut up now, so I'll just get into the video now, because I've been talking for way too long now. Icebreaker is so incredibly boring. Help. I'm on page 50. Never have I ever read a book this slowly. It's just, it's not giving so far. It's not giving it for me. I just find it incredibly boring. But obviously I'm like literally in the beginning. I read the first 50 pages, which went so slow for some reason. Like, I was just not feeling it, but who knows, maybe it'll pick up a pace later on. Like, I'm giving it a few more chapters, like, maybe till 100 pages, 150, maybe 200. If it's not giving by any of those time points, I'm gonna DNF this. I'm sorry, I really wanted it to... I mean, I'm getting ahead of myself. I'm only in the first 50 pages, but they're so boring. Nothing is happening. Nothing is happening. It's just... there's so many names, too. I cannot read this properly. I'm, like, reading, and there's, like, a name, and I'm like, wait, who the fuck were they again? And I, like, have to go back a few pages, like, who were they again? And I'm finally starting to get who is who. But, Jesus, why... why are we talking about so many different characters in the first 50 pages? I don't understand. It's boring. It's hard to read. That's my opinion on it so far. But I am going to give it a few more chapters to see if it does pick up. If not, I'm literally DNFing it. I don't even care at this point. I'll probably get rid of it too. But yeah, I'm gonna give it a chance still. So we'll see. We'll see. We'll see. Hello, it's Thursday. I did not film yesterday, and I have a good reason, okay? One of her chickens died. Very sudden, very unexpectedly. We don't know how she died. Like, she didn't have any wounds or anything, or, you know, any illness. So, it was just a very sudden death, and I needed a moment to grieve her. You might think that's silly for a chicken, but I get it. My chickens are really important to me. They're not like, you know, egg machines or for slaughter. They're my pets, you know, so I was pretty sad when I found her. So that's why I didn't film yesterday. If my voice sounds weird, I'm also a bit sick and I have like a throat infection, so I'm sorry about that. But here's the tea. I DNF'd Icebreaker. Sorry. I gave it up until like page 80. And it was so boring that I was like, no, I am not reading this. I'm not. For me, it just did not live up to the hype. Sorry. Maybe if I gave it more time, I would have ended up liking it. But if I'm 80 pages into the book and I'm still like, oh, this is so boring. Sorry, I'm not gonna push myself to read the rest. Like, I might someday, pick this up again. Maybe, but for now, DNF. However, I did start reading Solitaire, and I loved it. I loved this so much. Literally, I started reading it yesterday, and I literally, in one sitting, when I first started, read up to page 82. Because I was like hooked. I was like, I want to keep reading. But then I needed to go to bed because it was getting late, so I was like, okay, I'm gonna stop reading. Gonna go to bed and I will read tomorrow. Yes. And it's Thursday. I don't know if you remember from the beginning of the video, but it's Thursday, which means it's Waterstones Day. Hallelujah. And I am going to read Solitaire on the way there because the drive is about an hour, a little over an hour, and then the drive back is again a little over an hour. So I have, like, let's say 3 hours. That I can, in the car, that I can read this, so I will. Because I really like it. And it's really... Alice Osman just does such a fantastic job, like, all the time. But yeah, I'm gonna read this in the car, and I'll see you when I'm at Waterstones. Hello, we're currently Friday. Yesterday I went to Waterstones and I spent way too much money because I have a bag full of books. How about that? It was like so much fun. I've never been to Waterstones. Obviously it's in Brussels. I don't really go to Brussels very often just to go to a bookstore. But I'm really happy that I got to go because also the girl that was like at the checkout, she was so sweet. Like, I commented on her, like, I gave her a compliment on her lanyard. She had, like, a lanyard with a bunch of pins on it. And she was like, oh, you have such a good choice in books here. And she was just so nice. And I did maybe have a little bit of gay panic because she was just so cute and so wholesome. And yeah, and I'll never see her ever again. So that's kind of sad. But yeah, I got a bunch of books and I'm gonna do a haul for you right now. But first I'm gonna talk about Solitaire. I did indeed read Solitaire in the car ride, almost the entire car ride, and I got up to page 194, so I made quite a bit of progress. I'm gonna read some more today, maybe even finish it today. If not today, yeah, then I'll definitely finish it tomorrow. But yeah, let's just get straight into the book haul for now. I'm cutting that out. Okay, so first book that I got right here is the Heartstopper yearbook. I just think this is so cute. It's just a bunch of artwork from Alice in here and like information about her and the characters and all that stuff. And I think that's just so neat. And like every character also like has a song. And I just think this is so nice. And I'm gonna go through this today because I'm really, really intrigued. I really want to know what happened and like how Alice Osman like came up with it and more information about Heartstopper. If you didn't know, I'm a big Heartstopper fan, okay? Not just the series, also the graphic novels and the short novels. So I'm really happy that this was actually the last one they had in the store. I was also looking for This Winter by Alice Osman and I couldn't find it, so I asked one of the workers there if they still had them in stock. Sadly, they didn't, so I'm gonna have to order that one and, you know, get it that way. So yeah, this is the first book I got, is the Heartstopper yearbook. Next, Ninth House by Leigh Bardugo. I've wanted this one for ages. It just sounds super interesting. I feel like it gives probably like Dark Academia vibes. And like, it's like crime, mystery, Dark Academia, everything I love. So I'm really excited to read Ninth House 2. I've heard many good things about this, but then again, I did hear many good things about Icebreaker and I hated Icebreaker, sorry. Icebreaker? No, thank you. But yeah, I'm really excited about Ninth House and I really hope I will like this. This was like one of the first books I picked up when I was there. But the first one I picked up was actually The Book Thief. But yeah, Ninth House. Next, we have a book that I've wanted for a long time, and that is Ace of Spades. I've wanted this one for so long. It sounds like so interesting. And yeah, I'm just really excited to read this one. I'm probably gonna read this really soon because I've wanted it for a long time and they never had it at my local bookstore. And they did have it online, but I didn't order it online. I wanted to see if they had it at Waterstones, and they did. It's not exactly the cover I wanted, but I still love this cover a lot, but I like the other cover more. But yeah, I'm really, really excited to read this one too. So basically it kind of gives a solitaire vibes from what I read on the back. Like, there's this secret person that like, or it actually gives me more, what's the series called? There's a series on Netflix about like a guy that posts all these secrets of the students online and like during like school presentations and stuff. I feel like it's kind of give this vibes, that vibes, so I'm really excited because I really like that series. I did watch it, but I forgot what it's called. But it's giving that vibe from the back side, so. The next one I got is Tomorrow and Tomorrow and Tomorrow. I've heard so many good things about this. Yeah, I'm really excited about this one too. I've heard many good things about this. I actually really love the cover too. I think it's very nice. Like, that's a nice cover right here. It's like the silver thingies. So basically it's like childhood friends being like getting back together and like falling in love, I guess. That's kind of my favorite trope in romance, like childhood friends, and then in teen years they end up being like lovers after they reunite. Actually, my book Kissing in Swimming Pools that I wrote is the exact same trope. Like Mason and Caleb were childhood best friends, had a fallout, and then they, you know, get back to being friends in their teen years, and they end up falling in love. I just think it's probably a little bit overused, but yeah, I did write a book exactly like that, so I think I'm gonna really enjoy this one too. So for Kissing in Swimming Pools is gay. This one is not gay. Next one, also one that I've wanted for a long time, and that is Bunny. Like, yes. So yeah, I don't really have much to say about this because it's pretty vague what I've heard about it, but apparently it's like really popular and I really want to read it, so I did get Bunny. And I actually had this on my wish list for a long time, so I'm glad I finally found it. And I really love this cover. Like, that is a bright cover that's like neon pink, but it's really, really pretty, so I'm really excited to read this one as well. Let's move on to the next one. Oh yeah, oh yeah, A Dark Inheritance. So apparently, these people in this family basically die at their 18th, like they have a curse on them. Because, so no one can inherit, like, you know, the inheritance. So, they all die, and he's, like, convinced, like, I'm gonna die on my 18th, because I have this curse on me. And then there's, like, an opportunity to break the curse, and, like, you know, it's, like, his chains at redemption. I just really read that from the last line that is on the back cover. But I really, really am interested in this, and I want to read this really soon. Actually, yeah, this is not even long at all. It's like 185 pages. No, not 100, sorry, 380, yeah, 85 pages. So that's pretty, I think, yeah, I'll read this. I keep saying this on every book that I'll read it soon. But I have so many books on my TBR. I just got a bunch more. Great. At least I've been reading a lot. Next one we have... Wait, let me get these out. These are two books, actually. And that is... Good Girl, Bad Blood, and As Good As Dead. I already have A Good Girl's Guide to Murder. And now I have the other two ones, too. And here's the thing. I wanna do the same thing that Katie did and read all three of these in one video, like in 1 week, and I think I'm gonna do that pretty soon. So if you're interested in me reading the Good Girl's Guide to Murder series in one video, then you should subscribe because it will be there soon. I will do this soon. So got these two to complete the collection. Why is this one so hefty? Holy shit. They just keep getting bigger, aren't they, by the book. This one is hefty. Holy. Then the last book I got is, I told you, The Book Thief. I've wanted this one for so long. Like, how cute is... I mean, it's devastating, you know? It's like the World War, I guess. Like, in Germany with the Nazis. And her parents are, like, taken away to a concentration camp. And basically she steals books. You know, and it's basically a war story, I guess. And I am really excited to read this one too. Also, this cover is just everything. I love this cover. Like, it also has like sparkle. This cover is just so pretty, I love it. But yeah, those are all the books I got. So, did I spend 130 euros yesterday on books? I did. Do I regret it? Not really. But yeah, those are all the books I got at Waterstones. I'm gonna read Solitaire for a bit. And I'll check back in with you later. So, yeah. Hello. It's a while later. This video should have been online last Sunday. And I was supposed to film another video that was supposed to go up. Tomorrow, but that ain't happening considering I didn't even film it, so. But I'm not gonna be fake with you right now. I'm gonna be transparent. Here's the thing. I have this thing called chronic depression. And yes, I did fall into a depressive episode since last time I filmed, which is when I finished reading Solitaire because of the reading sprints on TikTok Live with Molly. I just really couldn't handle like anything in the last almost a week now, and I just really wasn't up to filming, and I was just so overwhelmed with everything. Like, my brain just wasn't working, okay? It wasn't braining. But I have chronic depression, which means I'm gonna have these episodes for the rest of my life. And I know that, my parents know that, my family knows that, my doctors know that, my psychologist knows that. Everyone knows that. And that's just kind of something we have to deal with. And it's not... It happens, and yeah, it's just... It happens, and there's nothing really much I can do about it. I can just, like, learn how to cope with it better so I don't end up doing bad things again, you know? Like, I'm trying really hard to, like, not let it control my life. Like, I've been in therapy since I was, like, 12. And, yeah, I've been in and out of psychiatric hospitals between the ages of 13 and 20. Like, I think the longest I went without being admitted was about 10 months, and yeah. I mean, I'm finally, like, stable enough to deal with it at home, so that if I get in a depressive episode, it doesn't get so bad that I need to be admitted again. And I really hope it's gonna stay that way, because... Oh. But yeah, sometimes these episodes do leave me, like, paralyzed. Like, not like physically, not like literally, but like, paralyzed is in a form of I cannot get myself to do anything. Like, I took a big step yesterday and cleaned my room because I have OCD. so when a depressive episode gets so bad that I don't clean my room, it overwhelms me even more because my room is dirty, and I, like, literally, if I feel one crumb on the floor, I will have to vacuum my entire room. And I'm not over-exaggerating. You might think, like, that's crazy. Yeah, that's because it's a mental illness. It's called OCD. It's crazy, I know, but I cannot. Oh, my room needs to be cleaned, or I just, like, cannot. And right now it's kind of messy, because I was like, oh, I'm so transparent. No, but, like, I was cleaning my closet, and there's some clothes on my bed, and an empty bag. Where is it? An empty trash bag to held my saddle pads. Because I took them out and storaged them somewhere else. I'm just going completely off topic now. Anyways, back to script. I didn't film. I didn't read either. Which, I don't know. Either I get in a depressive episode and I read like crazy, or I get in a depressive... Either I get in a depressive episode and read like crazy, or I get in a depressive episode and not read at all. So there's no in-between, not a single in-between. But yeah, what did I do? I slept, I cried, and I wallowed in my own self-pity. But I think I'm finally out of the worst part, and it's just like uphill from here. I really hope I'm out of the deep end, because I'm tired. I'm exhausted. But enough talk about my depression. Let's talk about the bookish stuff, which is what you're all here for. Not to hear me talk about my depression for 5 minutes straight. I was supposed to like finish this reading vlog on Sunday, and then start a new one on Monday, and film another video for tomorrow, and yeah, well, that didn't happen because I had a little dip. But I'm just gonna pick this vlog up right here and merge the 2 weeks that were supposed to be two separate vlogs together. So that's what you're watching now. It's the next week now. Anyways, I'm gonna be going to the IKEA probably on Friday, so in 2 days, to get extra bookshelves, because I've run out of space, and you know, I have books laying around everywhere that don't have a home, which is not okay. Why are there random piles of books in my room? Not okay. I'm also going on Sunday, I'm going to watch a show jumping competition. If you didn't know, I am an equestrian. I ride horses, I do horseback riding, and I'm very passionate about it, and I do want to get into competing someday. And yeah, that's fun. I'm sure that's gonna cheer me up because, you know, horses. Horses. So I'm excited to go to the show jumping competition, go to the IKEA to get more bookshelves. And yeah, I'll just film a bit and take you with me. But I do want to take a moment to talk about Solitaire and the book that I'm gonna read next. So, Solitaire by Alice Osman. I enjoyed this a lot, and I'm glad I finally got the chance to get to know Tori as a character more. Like, Tori is very relatable to me, which makes me personally think she has the tism, you know, the tism. Because, like, all the things that are, like, relatable to me are all things that I do because of my autism. Like, there's a few lines in here, let me just, give me a second. Oh, right here. I just like individual songs. I find one song that I really love and then I listen to it for about 20 billion times until I hate it and I have ruined it for myself. Another one. I hate the phone. It's the worst invention in the history of the world because if you don't talk, nothing happens. You can't get by with simply listening and nodding your head in all the right places. You have to talk. You have no option. Is that not the most autistic thing you've ever heard? But no. Well, yes. But I think Tori is a great character, and I really, really did enjoy this book. I think Michael is a great character, too. He must have something. He has to be neurodivergent in some ways, to be honest. But, and I like the story, like the plot, like there's a secret block run by some secret people and they pull pranks on the school, which are mostly harmless, but then they start getting a bit serious and I'm like, okay, calm down, you're crossing the line into criminality now. Just saying. But yeah, I really enjoyed the book and I think Alice Osman deserves like all the praise she gets for Heartstopper. But also for Solitaire. I haven't read any of her other ones, except for the short novels, like the Heartstopper short novels. But I really want to read her other full novels, which are like I Was Born for This, Radio Silence, and Loveless. Yeah, I do want to read all of those too, because I think Alice Osman deserves all the praise she gets. I love Alice Osman, she's great. The book I want to read next is World After by Susan E. This is the second book in the Angel Fall trilogy. I read the first, like, Angel Fall, like, years ago, and I loved it, like, so much that, like, I just think it was absolutely great. I love the characters. I loved, like, the enemies to lovers, like, trope it had. I loved, you know, anything angels. I'm sold, really, to be honest. But I finally acquired the second and the third book in this trilogy after I read the last one, like, years ago. So I am gonna start reading the second one today. Probably I'm gonna, like, go on TikTok and find myself, like, a live that has, like, reading sprints and read for this evening instead of being in self-pity and crying. So I am gonna do that, so... because I sure do miss my bubbly self that depression has overshadowed right now, so... but yeah, I think I'm back, because I am no upgiver. Yeah. So, I'm gonna read some, and then I'll come back with an update sometime soon. I've been rambling for so long about my depression. This vlog is one big mess. Thank you, mental illness. Anyhow, the last clip you saw was at the IKEA. Since then, I did build the shelves. My mom built the shelves. And I put them where they were supposed to go. And I'll show you that in a minute, but I just wanna, like, talk for a second. I didn't go to the jumping today, and that's simply because the weather was horrendous. It was raining, it was like thundering, there was like lightning, there was so much rain, I swear to God. If I went outside for 1 second, I would have been soaked. Next, do I have any reading progress? Well, I'm about 60 pages into World After by Susan E. Yeah, that's it. I haven't read in like 2 days. Simply because I did not feel like reading, and I'm not gonna force myself to read. I feel like that's counterproductive. Like, if you're gonna force yourself through it, you're not gonna enjoy it, you're not gonna like what you're doing. And I like liking what I'm doing. So if I don't feel like reading, I'm not gonna read. What did I do instead? I gamed a lot. I played a lot of Sims 4, and I played a lot of Star Stable. If you didn't know, Star Stable is the number one online horse game. Not that I even care, blah blah blah. None of you probably even care about horses. If you do, then you probably know Star Stable. I mean, who in the horse world does not know? Who under the age of 25 in the horse world does not know Star Stable? Sorry. But anyways, this vlog went good in the beginning, and then it just went downhill after I got in my depressive episode. But I'm doing a lot better, like a lot better. Like, I have, like, yeah, I feel pretty good. I feel mostly okay, which is the goal. So that's good. Yesterday, I signed up for Second Chance Education. That was scary, because I just committed myself to Second Chance Education so that hopefully I'll have my high school degree in 2 years. If you didn't know, I don't have a high school degree because my mental illness and my chronic illnesses just kind of got in the way of my school life. So I did not get my high school diploma when I was like 18 like I was supposed to. I'm currently 21. I'm starting my second chance education, and it's 2 years, so I'll have my diploma by the age of 23, which is not too bad, to be honest. Like, I think that's pretty okay. But yeah, I will probably do a stationery haul because I love stationery. I will probably do a stationery haul, probably like next week or the week after that, because I have surgery on Wednesday, so I don't know how I'm going to be feeling to do the stationery haul like the days after that, so it's probably not going to be next week, but the week after that. So anyways, enough talking. I'm going to show you my shelves, and then I'm going to end this vlog because it's going nowhere at this point. but this is very real to me. This is kind of how my life goes. I never really know when a depressive episode is going to kick in, and I cannot prepare for it because, you know, I don't know when it's going to happen. So I started filming this vlog thinking it would be a nice little vlog, and then my depression hit and it went downhill. But that's just how it is for me, and like, I have to deal with it. It's going to interfere with my YouTube, it's going to interfere with my school, it's going to interfere with everything in my life. And yeah, I just have to deal with it and deal with the situation and see how I can make the best out of the situation. So yeah, let me just show you my shelves real quick. My mirror are dirty as hell, but here are my shelves. So I got two collets, one with two squares and one with three squares, so it would fit on my wardrobe. Like, all my clothes are in here. That's horse riding clothes, that's like pants and skirts, that's random clothes. There's more clothes. I have too many clothes. Okay, anyway. Up there are my plushies, because they used to be on my closet. And here we have my little warrior cat section. Just have my 1, 2, and 3 in paperbacks, and then my 4 in hardcover. And I do want to get like 4, 5, and 6 of series 1. But here, and this little cat, I'm not going to go in detail. Anyways, this is going to be my children horrors section. This is going to be my horse section. There's some information books here. And I ordered some equestrian novels. Books going to go here, books are going to go here. It's, currently it's empty. And that's because I'm going on a book buying ban until after Christmas. Because I'm probably going to get a bunch of books for Christmas and I need space for them. So I have space right here for them to go. So those are my shelves. Okay, so that's it for this vlog. I hope you didn't mind the mess that was the last part. It's life for me and I still wanted this vlog to go out, so here it is if you're watching it. But anyhow, thank you for watching my video. If you want to see more of me, then don't forget to subscribe. I post mostly bookish and witchy stuff, but I can post other things too, occasionally, because, you know, it's my mixed up mind and there's gonna be mixed up videos. But yeah, give this video a like if you liked it, if you like it, because it does sure help me out a lot and I do appreciate it. And yeah, bye.